So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back to another session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions and also about the courses. So let's begin with the very first question, which is about the green gold collection window at the Germany marketplace portal. So the question is, the government of India has dedicated a window, the green gold collection on the GEM portal, which is the government e-marketplace portal for the marketing of Dash. Now guys, if you know that the bamboo is known as green gold, then you could easily answer this question because bamboo is known as green gold. So this green gold collection window has been dedicated for the bamboo goods. So option A, bamboo goods, here should be the correct answer. But now let's talk about the news. What is the news? So the government of India has dedicated a window which is known as the green gold collection on the government e-marketplace portal for the marketing of bamboo goods. बैम्बू गुड्स की मार्केटिंग करने के लिए एक नई विंडो बनाई है गवर्नमेंट मार्केटप्लेस पे भारत सरकार ने, एंड इट इज द कलेक्टिव वर्क ऑफ द नेशनल बैम्बू मिशन एंड द गवर्नमेंट ई मार्केटप्लेस। नाउ दिस इज ऑब्वियसली हैज बीन डन टू प्रमोट द अडॉप्शन एंड यूज ऑफ बैम्बू प्रोडक्ट्स अमंग द गवर्नमेंट बायर्स। जो गवर्नमेंट बायर्स है, जो गवर्नमेंट ई मार्केटप्लेस पे जाके सामान खरीदते हैं, उनके बीच में अडॉप्शन एंड यूज ऑफ बैम्बू प्रोडक्ट्स को बढ़ाने के लिए दिस स्टेप हैज बीन टेकन बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। And this window, guys, will showcase a range of exquisitely handcrafted bamboo products, disposals, and office utility products which can be used in an office on the government e-marketplace portal. And it will definitely provide an opportunity, or you can say it will definitely provide the market access to the bamboo artisans, weavers, and the entrepreneurs who are dealing with the bamboo products. ऐसे entrepreneurs, ऐसे viewers, ऐसे artisans जो कि bamboo products के साथ deal करते हैं, उनको market provide कराया जाएगा and it will definitely increase their livelihood also, alright? So this is about this news and therefore the correct answer is what option A, bamboo goods, the very easy question और इसका जो answer है वो इसके question में ही छुपा हुआ था, green gold, bamboo is known as green gold, so here the correct answer is what, bamboo goods, alright? And now let's talk about question number 2. Dash of India has become a signatory of United Nations Global Compact's CEO water mandate to assist companies in developing, implementing and disclosing comprehensive water strategies and policies. So question mein CEO water mandate ke baare mein bata diya. The question itself is telling about the CEO water mandate. It is basically a global coalition to assist companies in developing, implementing and disclosing the comprehensive water strategies and policies. And these are the companies which strives to work towards the water management policies. ऐसी कंपनियां जो कि water management के towards काम करना चाहती हैं, उन सभी companies को comprehensive water strategies और policy develop करने में, implement करने में और disclose करने में मदद करता है CEO water mandate, which is basically a global coalition. And the news is that NTPC Limited has become a signatory of United Nations Global Compact CEO water mandate. Now, as I told you, it is a coveted league of companies focusing on different efficient water management. Efficient water management पे जो companies काम कर रही हैं, उनका ये group है, उनका एक league है. Now, talking more about this CEO water mandate. So, as we have discussed that this initiative demonstrates the commitment and efforts of companies to enhance their water and sanitation agendas, which are in line with the sustainable development goals that has to be achieved by the year 2030. And it has been designed to assist companies in developing, implementing and disclosing their comprehensive water strategies and policies. And it also provides a platform for the companies to link with like-minded businesses, public authorities, United Nations agencies, which are working towards this area of water management. Okay. So I hope this news is clear. And here the correct answer is what option A, NTPC Limited. NTPC guys is a Maharatna. It is a Maharatna under the Ministry of Power and it was declared as Maharatna in the year 2010. And Mr. Gurdeep Singh is the current CMD of this Maharatna NTPC Limited. And option A is the correct answer. And now let's talk about the World Environment Day 2021. So you have to consider these statements regarding World Environment Day 2021. And you have to identify the correct statements. So let's talk about this. So World Environment Day 2020-2021, the United Nations theme was Reimagine, Recreate and Restore. Reimagine, recreate, restore was the United Nations themes, but don't confuse it with India's theme. India's theme was promotion of biofuels for a better environment. Promotion of biofuels for a better environment was theme for India, while United Nations theme was reimagine, recreate and restore. I hope there is no confusion now. And these are some of the announcements that was made by Prime Minister on this World Environment Day. Now, can you tell me guys why World Environment Day is celebrated only on 5th June? What is so special about 5th June? Why it is celebrated on 5th June only? Write down in the comments. So first of all, a report of the expert committee on roadmap for ethanol blending in India 2020-2025 was launched by the Prime Minister. And under this report, the target of achieving 20% ethanol blending petrol has been preponed to the year 2025. Earlier, this target was 2030 and now it has been preponed to 2025. Also remember, the 10% ethanol blending target, 10% ka jo ethanol blending target hai, that we have to achieve by the year 2022. And currently the ethanol blending in our petrol is around 8.5%, jo ki kitna abhi 8.5% ke aas paas hai, jo ki hume 2022 tak we have to achieve this 10% ethanol blending target by 2022, while till 2025 we have to achieve 20% ethanol blending as stated by this report and the Prime Minister of India. So till 2014 on an average only 1.5% of ethanol could be blended in India, but it has now reached around 8.5%. Now there is this project E100 pilot project that was launched in Pune for the production and distribution of ethanol across the country. And remember, it is a pilot project. If it is a success, then it will be launched pan India. Remember, E100 is a प्योर इथेनॉल फ्यूल. E100 जो है वो क्या है, प्योर इथेनॉल फ्यूल है. एंड ऑयल मार्केटिंग कंपनीज कैन नाउ सेल E100 फॉर कंपैटिबल व्हीकल्स. सो ऐसे व्हीकल्स जिसमें E100 जो यानी कि जो प्योर इथेनॉल फ्यूल है वो कंपैटिबल होगा, उनके लिए ऑयल मार्केटिंग कंपनीज आर नाउ अलाउड टू सेल दिस E100 प्योर इथेनॉल फ्यूल. एंड रिमेंबर, दिस इज अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट दैट हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड इन पुणे. And now there is a E20 notification that will be released by the government of India. And this report, this notification will allow companies to sell this 20% ethanol blended petrol from 1st April 2023 itself. And BIS specification for ethanol blends E12 and E15. So 1 April 2023 ke baad se 20% ethanol blended petrol hamare desh mein bikna start ho jayega. And we have to achieve the target of this 20% ethanol blending by the year 2025. Iska matlab ye hai कि हमारे देश का जितना भी पेट्रोल होगा, द कंप्लीट पेट्रोल, द ओवरऑल पेट्रोल ऑफ अवर कंट्री विल बी 20% इथेनॉल ब्लेंडेड बाय द ईयर 2025. बट जितना भी ब्लेंड हो जाएगा 2023 तक, 1st अप्रैल 2023 तक, दैट विल बी देयर फॉर सेल ऑन स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 1st अप्रैल 2023. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट वर्ल्ड एनवायरमेंट डे. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू मार्क द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इंडियाज थीम फॉर वर्ल्ड एनवायरमेंट डे was ecosystem restoration. No, this was not the theme of India. And remember, ecosystem restoration is ye word kafi jagah aapko report mein dikhega. Kai news channels ne aur kai newspapers ne ye bataya hai that United Nation theme is eco restoration. But remember guys, it is not the United Nation theme for this year. Ecosystem restoration basically it is a decade. It is a decade 2021 se leke 2030. Ye ecosystem restoration decade hai. This is not the theme for 2021 Environment Day. All right. Target of achieving 20% ethanol blending in petrol in India has been postponed by 5 years. No, it has been preponed by 5 years. In fact, to 2025. And E100 pilot project has been launched in New Delhi. No, not in New Delhi. It has been launched in Pune, which means this statement is also correct. So therefore, option E, all are incorrect, should be the correct answer. And now, guys, let's move ahead to question number 4, which is the last question for today. You have to consider the following statement with regards to CEM Industrial Deep Decarbonization Initiative, and you have to identify the correct statement. CEM, Clean Energy Ministerial Industrial Deep Decarbonization Initiative, ye news mein isliye hai because recently India and the United Kingdom, it is in news because India, remember this initiative is not new. This initiative is not new. इसमें अभी कुछ न्यूज आई है इससे रिलेटेड, दैट इज व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग दिस. सो एंड द न्यूज इज दैट द इंडिया एंड यूनाइटेड किंगडम हैव लॉन्च्ड अ न्यू वर्क स्ट्रीम टू प्रमोट इंडस्ट्रियल एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी अंडर द क्लीन एनर्जी मिनिस्टीरियल्स Industrial Deep Decarbonization Initiative, all right, and it is coordinated by United Nations Development Industrial Organization. And it was this new work stream, this new work stream was launched in the ongoing 12th CEM meeting. CEM stands for Clean Energy Ministerial, that is being virtually hosted by Chile. Now, talking about this meeting, so the objective of this meeting, guys, is to infuse green technologies and to stimulate and to boost the demand for low carbon industrial material. Industrial material aisa ho jahan pe carbon ki kami ho, yani ki jahan pe kam carbon use hua ho, aise products ki demand ko stimulate karna, and to also infuse the green technologies within the economies is the basic objective of this meeting. And India is committed to cut emissions intensity per unit of GDP by 33-35% by the year 2030, and this is stated by the nationally determined contributions of India. And the commitment hinges on effective deployment of low carbon technologies and energy intensive sectors like iron and steel. And talking about clean energy ministerial, so remember it is a high level global forum that was established in the year 2009 at the United Nations Framework for Convention on Climate Change Conference of Parties in Copenhagen in the year 2009 it was formed, and currently 29 countries are part of it, including India. And remember, it is aimed at promoting policies and programs that advance clean energy technology and to share the lessons learned and the best practices in the field of energy, in the field of renewable energy, in the field of green energy. Okay, and talking about this industrial deep decarbonization initiative, so it is clear that it is an initiative of Clean Energy Ministerial. It is basically a global coalition of public and private organizations. And these public and private organizations are those who are working to stimulate demand for low carbon industrial materials. Aise public or private organizations jo ki low carbon industrial materials ki demand ko stimulate karne ke liye kaam kar rahe hain, ye un companies ka, un organization ka global coalition hai. And this initiative has been supported by Germany and Canada, with more countries expecting to join soon. And its basic objective is the same as clean energy ministerials, that is to infuse green technologies and to stimulate demand for low carbon industrial material. All right. And now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. All right. So 29 countries are part of CEM, including India. Absolutely correct. The objective of IDDI is to infuse green technologies and stimulate demand for low carbon industrial material. Also correct. India and the UK have launched a new work stream to promote industry. This is also absolutely correct, guys. So all are correct, should be the correct answer. Option D will be the correct answer here. All right. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.